On October 26th last year, ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi was killed during a raid by the U.S. Special Forces in northwest Syria. This was a major blow for the terrorist group. But 1 year after his death, how is the ISIS group coping with the death of one of its biggest leaders?
Bravo 1, the commandos are moving up to my building, just so you know.
Last night, the United States brought the world's number one terrorist leader to justice. Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi is dead. And that's why he died like a dog. He died like a coward. He was whimpering, screaming, and crying.
The killing of Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, the self-proclaimed caliph of the Islamic State, is not the end of the ISIS. But what ISIS becomes now is not clear either. Even when the US makes major military progress against a given movement, the group either recovers or some new form of terrorism emerges in its place. Politics is politics, but there are serious dangers in making claims about the ability to defeat terrorism in general and ISIS in particular. ISIS is no exception. It is still active in Syria, Iran, and other countries. Furthermore, US official intelligence and military reporting makes this all too clear, regardless of political claims to the contrary. So does the historical record. Just days after Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi was killed in a raid by US Special Forces in October, the ISIS announced the name of the man who replaced him as leader. But the true identity of Abu Ibrahim al-Hashimi al-Qureshi remains shrouded in mystery, and with it, the organization's strategy going forward. Trump claimed that he knew exactly who the successor was, but soon after that, senior US officials said that the new leader was completely unknown. Under Baghdadi, who also avoided the limelight, the ISIS experimented with running a proto-state, producing school textbooks and creating its own currency. Since the jihadist organization was driven out of its last patch of Syrian territory, the village of Baghuz, it resorted mainly to guerrilla tactics. If Qureshi is to avoid an international leadership challenge, he will be forced to step out of the shadows. The ability of terrorists and extremists to exploit the internet and global media remains a serious tool for terrorism and extremism that goes far beyond national boundaries and any given terrorist or extremist organization. After a 5-year absence from public view, al-Baghdadi had appeared April 29th in an 18-minute propaganda video. In a black tunic with a Kalashnikov rifle at his side, he stated that ISIS's fight against the West was far from over. The danger still looms large from al-Baghdadi's call to his followers to shift from larger attacks to smaller actions outside Iraq and Syria. Even so, al-Baghdadi's death, while partly symbolic, has silenced maybe the most inspirational terrorist voice that remained. West Asia Bureau Report, we on World is One.